thanks for tuning in. Today we're here to tell you about the first principle of green chemistry, prevention, which can apply to all facets of life and not just to chemists doing experiments in the lab. Today I'm joined by Cookie and Laura in the kitchen, who will demonstrate that it's better to prevent waste than to treat it or clean it up afterwards. We've asked Cookie and Laura to both make the same pasta dish, and they'll be competing to see who can feed their hungry friends first. They both had the chance to go over the recipe and buy the ingredients they needed. They are also allowed to use whatever they need in the kitchen, but we've asked them to leave everything they use on the counter when they're finished with it. All right, it seems both our contestants are all set. So, ready, set, go! Mention that. Looks like you better get to work. Laura is almost finished and has a much smaller mess to clean up than you.
It's gonna take forever.
Looks like you may have learned a lesson here. Yes, you finished making your pasta first, but by not planning ahead and not working carefully, you left yourself a big mess to clean up. Let's recap a few points so we can tie what we've learned back to chemistry. Use the minimum amount of material required to get the job done. Laura took the time to find out exactly what amount of water was needed to cook a package of spaghetti, while Cookie used much more than he needed to. Imagine if this water was a toxic solvent in a chemistry experiment. Cookie would have much more waste that needs to be treated and disposed of than Laura, who made sure to use the minimum amount. Plan ahead to prevent ending up with extra materials that will go to waste. Laura went over the recipe carefully, bought only what she needed, and doesn't have nearly as many leftover ingredients as Cookie. She even found a use for the extra wine, which otherwise would be considered waste in this experiment. In many cases, chemicals, like food, will go bad after they've been opened. It's better to open only what is needed or plan to use any excess reagents. With all the leftovers, I hope you plan on eating spaghetti and sauce every day this week, Cookie. Work safely to prevent accidents, which can be dangerous and create unnecessary extra waste. Rushing and not being careful, in the kitchen and especially in a chemistry lab, makes accidents much more likely to occur. These can be very dangerous and can cause messes that are much more difficult to clean up. I see Cookie is having a tough time cleaning up that pan where he mixed the cheese before the tomatoes. By planning ahead and working carefully, Laura hardly left any mess to clean up, and ended up serving your friends a delicious pasta dinner first. So remember, principle number one says it's better to prevent waste than to treat it or clean it up after it's been created. I think after today, Cookie would have to agree. Thanks for watching. Make sure you like this video, comment, and subscribe to see the rest of our series on the principles of green chemistry. If you want to learn more about the Green Chemistry Initiative, check us out at our website or on Facebook or Twitter.